We here live in society in Western country. Mosques here is not just a mosque. It's a place where we can save the faith of our generation. So any pound you spend in this mosque, you spend in the next generation. But when we said that, many people, all their bills comes in front of them. They remember in that time, gas bill, electricity bill, everything come in front of you. Why? Allah said in Surah Al-Baqarah,
الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين يا أيها الذين آمنوا أنفقوا من طيبات ما كسبتم ومما أخرجنا لكم من الأرض ولا تيمموا الخبيث منه تنفقون ولستم بآخذيه إلا أن تغمضوا فيه واعلموا أن الله غني حميد الشيطان يعدكم الفقر ويأمركم بالفحشاء والله يعدكم مغفرة منه وفضلا والله واسع عليم يؤتي الحكمة من يشاء ومن يؤت الحكمة فقد أوتي خيرا كثيرا وما يذكر إلا أولو الألباب وما أنفقتم من نفقة أو نذرتم من نذر فإن الله يعلمه وما للظالمين من أنصار إن تبدوا الصدقات فنعما هي وإن تخفوها وتؤتوها الفقراء فهو خير لكم ويكفر عنكم من سيئاتكم والله بما تعملون خبير ليس عليك هداهم ولكن الله يهدي من يشاء وما تنفقوا من خير فلأنفسكم وما تنفقون إلا ابتغاء وجه الله وما تنفقوا من خير يوفى إليكم وأنتم لا تظلمون للفقراء الذين أحصروا في سبيل الله لا يستطيعون ضربا في الأرض يحسبهم الجاهل أغنياء من التعفف تعرفهم بسيماهم لا يسألون الناس إلحافا وما تنفقوا من خير فإن الله به عليم الذين ينفقون أموالهم بالليل والنهار سرا وعلانية فلهم أجرهم عند ربهم ولا خوف عليهم ولا هم يحزنون الذين يأكلون الربا لا يقومون إلا كما يقوم الذي يتخبطه الشيطان من المس ذلك بأنهم قالوا إنما البيع مثل الربا وأحل الله البيع وحرم الربا فمن جاءه موعظة من ربه فانتهى فله ما سلف وأمره إلى الله، ومن عاد فأولئك أصحاب النار هم فيها خالدون. يمحق الله الربا ويربي الصدقات، والله لا يحب كل كفار أثيم. إن الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وأقاموا الصلاة وآتوا الزكاة لهم أجرهم عند ربهم ولا خوف عليهم ولا هم يحزنون. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وذروا ما بقي من الربا إن كنتم مؤمنين. فإن لم تفعلوا فأذنوا بحرب من الله ورسوله، وإن تبتم فلكم رؤوس أموالكم لا تظلمون ولا تظلمون. وإن كان ذو عسرة فنظرة إلى ميسرة، وأن تصدقوا خير لكم إن كنتم تعلمون. واتقوا يوما ترجعون فيه إلى الله، ثم توفى كل نفس ما كسبت وهم لا يظلمون.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. اللهم صلِّ وسلِّم على عبدك ورسولك وحبيبك ونبيك سيدنا محمد. We still in سورة البقرة this week. And we said before that one of the main themes of Surah Al-Baqarah is the concept of ibadah. That's ibadah is not just praying, fasting, go to Hajj and all these virtues. Ibadah is very wide concept in Islam. Everything in this life type of ibadah. And among these aspects of ibadah, there is very important aspect, which is money. How do you look to money? What's the concept of money in Islam? Spending is very, very important. It took a big portion in Surah Al-Baqarah. In the end of Surah Al-Baqarah, there is page after page after page just about spending. Why? Because Quran wants to build a nation, the best nation, ummatan wasata. Every nation need money, need spending, need a lot of money. So Quran want to reshape how you look to money. From the beginning in the second ayah, and he elaborate that in the end of the surah. That's why the longest ayah in Quran is about financial transaction, how to contract the debt. This is the longest ayah in Quran, which indicate the importance of money in our deen. The first point here, which is in the second ayah of Surah Al-Baqarah, الَّذِينَ يُؤْمِنُونَ بِالْغَيْبِ وَيُقِيمُونَ الصَّلَاةِ وَمِمَّا رَزَقْنَاهُمْ يُنْفِقُونَ. Look, at the beginning, he didn't say يؤمنون بالغيب ويقيمون الصلاة ويؤتون الزكاة. No. ومما رزقناهم ينفقون. Why? Because this is the most important point in money. Your money is not yours. Your money is not yours. You have to understand this. It's belong to Allah تبارك وتعالى. وَمِمَّا رَزَقْنَاهُمْ They donate, they spend from what we have provide to them. So it's not yours. That's the first thing. Therefore, you have to ask the owner of that money, what should I do with this money? The real owner is Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. We are servants. So we should ask what we should do with this money. Exactly like Sahaba in the same surah Al-Baqarah, yas'alunaka madha yunfiqun. Do you see? Sahaba said, okay, what we should do with our money? They learn the lesson. So the money, the real owner is Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. We are slaves, we are servants, we just wait from the commands from Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. He said to us, he is the owner of the money, but he gave it to us to spend it in this dunya. However, whatever you spend, the first one will get benefit is you, not the poor, not the orphan, not the people in needy. The first one will get benefit when I spend money is me. قال تعالى في سورة البقرة وما تنفقوا من خير فلأنفسكم. It's to your benefit in the day of judgment. Even here to purify your soul, purify your money. So remember this when you spend money, when you donate. You know, every time when we talk about donation in masajid, if when said mosque need, we here live in society in Western country, mosques here is not just a mosque. It's a place where we can save the faith of our generation. So any pound you spend in this mosque, you spend in the next generation. But when we said that, many people, all their bills comes in front of them. They remember in that time, gas bill, electricity bill. Everything come in front of you. Why? Allah said in Surah Al-Baqarah, الشيطان يعيدكم الفقر. When you want to donate, Shaitan remind you now. What about your bills? What about you need to buy a new phone? You need to... يعيدكم الفقر ويأمركم بالفحشاء. However, when you go to spend, to buy a new phone or a decent car or anything, you don't remember your bills that time. You remember your bills just when you want to donate. Because Shaitan in that time wants you to spend, spend, even if you don't need it. Just spend. So we are servant, we just look, waiting for what Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala say. So he said, whatever you donate is for yourself in the day of judgment. That's the first concept, how we look at money. Then the second point is the importance of spending in this ummah. You know the ayatul birr, laysa al-birra an tuwallu wujuhakum qibal al-mashriq. This ayah is point out the general, the main aspects of our deen. Start with عقيدة ولكن البر من آمن بالله واليوم الآخر والملائكة والكتاب والنبيين. Then وآت المال. Immediately after عقيدة. And he will say after that والذين يقيمون الصلاة ويؤتون الزكاة. So why he made this info? Just to highlight, to indicate the importance of spending in our religion. It's very, very important. Then the third point, when you want to spend, when Sahaba ask, يَسْأَلُونَكَ مَاذَا يُنْفِقُونَ? Because it's not my money. Oh my Lord, where you want me to spend? He give you the priority. The first category is your parents. Second category, your relatives. Third category, orphan. Then needy, then travelers when they are in needy. So I mean parents and relatives before orphans and poor. Very important concept in Quran. Always. Always in Quran, relatives before poor people. Subhanallah. Why? Because if every one of us take care of his relatives, then society will be much better. So always remember your relatives in back home. When you want to buy a new phone for your boy or girl, wait a minute. It's halal. However, remember, what about your relatives in back home? Maybe they need just shelter. They need food. They need drink. They need essential in this haya. And you spend a lot without thinking about them. That's why Quran remind us, your relatives. Another point that Quran want to make also in Surah Al-Baqarah, when you spend, remember it's not your money, then when you spend in the sake of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, only in the sake of Allah. Because some people, when they spend, they remind the beggars, the poor people, I gave you that day. I gave you. I did that for you. If you do that, then you waste your rewards. No rewards at all. Or you didn't give someone, but you say very hurtful words. If someone knocks your door and you don't have, you have to say nice words for the beggars. And remember, when you spend in the sake of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. Because in the pre-Islamic era, they always praise spending in poetry a lot. But spending in that time, not for the sake of Allah, just for reputation. I want people to praise me. In Quran, no, just in the sake of Allah. Another also point in Surah Al-Baqarah, when you spend, choose, when you want to donate, choose the best from what you have. Don't choose something you don't like it, you don't want it, something is useless at your home and say, oh, this is for charity. No. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا أَنْفِقُوا مِنْ طَيِّبَاتِ مَا كَسَبْتُمْ. And he give us example. Imagine you are the poor people. You are the poor person. And someone gave you something useless. You will accept it because you are in need. But with close eye. Remember this also. When you donate, some people they said, okay, oh brothers, oh my daughters and sisters, look at the clothes which is now finished. And gather these clothes, we will donate. In the sake of Allah. No, this is not in the sake of Allah. This is because now useless. That's another point in Surah Al-Baqarah also. Another point in Surah Al-Baqarah is very important because spending money is difficult for many people. Difficult. Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala in Surah Al-Baqarah give us example. It's not donation, it's a loan. Give me a loan. Allah Almighty said, oh my servant, can you give me a loan and I will return it to you and multiply it for you. La ilaha illallah. Why in this form? Because he wants us to stay away from shaitan. He wants good for us. And to emphasize this more, Ayatul Kursi. Anybody can tell me Ayatul Kursi, which ayah? Number, ayah number? 255. What's ayah 254 before Ayatul Kursi? MashaAllah. Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu anfiqo. Spend. Spending before Ayatul Kursi immediately. And when Allah finished Ayatul Kursi and the story of Ibrahim, Uzair, immediately he returned to the topic of spending again. It means Ayatul Kursi is in between spending. Why? Because when you spend generously, this need iman, need high level in iman. Need high level in iman. To feel the pain of Muslims around the world, this is need iman. Not just give 10 pounds and you think I did everything. It's need iman. So Allah remind us from Ayatul Kursi. Last thing, when Allah Ta'ala in the end of آيات الإنفاق spending, he mentioned riba, usury. Why he spend mentioned riba with? Because riba is opposite of charity. And inshallah, in the coming months, inshallah, I will make a course just about all the ahkam of financial transactions and highlight a lot of ahkam of riba, inshallah, if Allah give us life. But here, just in short, riba with sadaqah, because Allah tabarak wa ta'ala want to spend. And when someone come to you and he need a loan, it means he is in need. Allah encourage us to give him donation, and that's for ourselves in the day of judgment. If we can't, then at least give him a qard hasan, a loan without interest, because he's in need. Because he's in need, you want to take advantage of this. And Allah said, وَإِن كَانَ ذُو عُسْرَةٍ فَنَظِيرَةٌ إِلَى مَيْسَرَةٍ. You give him a loan, after 3 months, return it. After 3 months now, he said, sorry, I can't return it now. Can you give me 2 months more? Allah said, if you give him, that's better than you, if you just knew. And even if you reduce the loan, that will be better. And when Allah said, that will be better, خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ, he mentioned after that immediately, وَاتَّقُوا يَوْمًا تُرْجَعُونَ فِيهِ إِلَى اللَّهِ. Always remind us, how can I reduce the loan? It's my money. وَاتَّقُوا يَوْمًا تُرْجَعُونَ فِيهِ إِلَى اللَّهِ. In the day of judgment, you need just one good deed. What if you reduce that loan from your brother? Brothers, we live in very difficult situation now, in this financial crisis, and many of our brothers and sisters, they are in need. If you can't donate, which is this better, at least give them loan and give them time till the time of ease come to them. This very, we are believers. We are not like other people. We have a unique concept of spending from Surah Al-Baqarah and the whole Quran. And then Allah tabarak wa ta'ala said, the problem with riba is it causes corruption with the whole society, not just individuals. Why? You think in riba it just affects individuals? No. It affects the whole society. And that's a big lesson, inshallah, in the future of Allah give us life, bi-idhnillah ta'ala. So the core lesson today, reshape the concept of the money in our deen. How you look to the money, it's not yours, it's his. And then spend generously for yourself, not for your brothers. And your relatives is the priority. And spend from the best you have. And then in the end, try to borrow money for your brothers and be patient in that case. May Allah tabarak wa ta'ala give us generosity. May Allah tabarak wa ta'ala make us among believers who say sami'na wa ata'na wa sallallahu ala abdi rasul sayyidina.